Animals see the world in thousands of different ways. In the animal kingdom, the difference between life and death may not be what you see, but how you see. It's not just the structure of the eye that helps a top predator. Location is important too. Big predators like the cheetah need to keep both eyes on the prize. They use peripheral vision to stay alert to potential threats, but their main focus is always straight in front. Which is why most carnivorous mammals have forward-facing eyes with a relatively narrow field of view. But because each eye sees the object from a slightly different angle, each one projects a slightly different variation of the same scene onto the retina. The brain superimposes these two variations to create a single 3D image, so that carnivores are able to accurately judge depth and distance. Useful when a gazelle is firmly in sight. As the cheetah runs, it keeps its prey in focus on a sharp, narrow band in the middle of its field of view. This is particularly important for keeping a moving target in focus when going in for the kill. This time, the gazelle loses to the spectacular vision, speed, and accuracy of the cheetah. But as the sun sets, the cheetah's eyesight starts to fail, and it hunkers down for the night, as the lion starts to wake up. Like the cheetah, the lion's eyes are on the front of his head, but he has some structural advantages that allow him to hunt at night. Thanks to a special layer of cells called tapetum lucidum, or bright tapestry, the lion's eyes are able to find its prey in the fading light. Tapetum lucidum refers to a layer of crystals that sits at the back of the eye and reflects light back onto the retina, like a mirror. The eye and brain can now form a brighter image. One of the visible effects of tapetum lucidum is eyeshine, eyes that glow in the dark. There really ain't no way to hide those lion eyes. The scariest glowing eyes by far belong to one of the deadliest night stalkers, the tiger. The tapetum lucidum coupled with the structure of the tiger's retina gives it laser-sharp vision in the dead of night. Their retina is perfectly adapted for night vision. They can see movement in almost pitch-dark conditions. Nighttime predators have a lot of rods in their retina, so they see well in the dark. But only two types of cones, so they just see blue and green. Color is not as important when you're hunting in the dark. Prowling the jungle in the middle of the night, the eye of the tiger seeks out living prey. This forward-facing setup is perfect for a predator, but pitiful for the prey. Grazing animals must be on high alert in case danger is near. Excellent peripheral vision is a must, so their eyes are on the side of their head. Because they feed on grass, they don't need the same depth perception as hunters. After all, there's no need to stalk or ambush plants. Grass is a relatively new type of plant, about 40 million years old. Animals that adapted to eat it had to move to the wide open spaces of the prairies. These conspicuous areas have no cover for protection. So grazing animals adapted their eyesight to have as wide a field of view as possible. This allows them to detect predators from almost every angle and quickly see which escape routes are available if they're attacked. For some animals, it's not about the hunt. It's about foraging for food. So how does vision help with that? Gorillas see things exactly the way humans do. They see the yellow mango and the green celery. The red ball clearly caught this little gorilla's attention. Turns out gorillas and other great apes like orangutans and chimpanzees have a much wider range of color vision than most mammals. Color vision is a relatively recent development for primates and a big evolutionary advantage. The earliest primates were tiny nocturnal creatures that stayed close to the ground and only came out at night. That way, they could have dinner and not be dinner. As night crawlers, they relied more on seeing shapes and movement than color. At this point, they used their sense of smell more than their eyesight. Eventually, primates moved up into the trees, but they still had limited color vision. These lemurs are direct descendants of the early tree-living primates. Like other nocturnal animals, they have a lot of rod cells in their eyes, which help them see well in the dark. But fewer cones for color detection. They see in shades of green and blue because they have just two types of color photoreceptors. This is called dichromatic vision. The same goes for many of the monkeys of Central and South America, like these squirrel monkeys. But at some point in their evolution, old world monkeys from Africa and Asia, like baboons and macaques, evolved trichromatic vision. They have three types of color receptor cones, not just sensitive to blue and green, but red as well. This type of vision requires medium to bright light. But as old world monkeys became diurnal and foraged in the day, it worked to their advantage. Scientists believe primates evolved trichromatic vision because it helped pick out good fruit to eat, which helped them survive. One way to tell the ripeness of fruit is by touching it to see how soft it is. But it's usually easier to tell by looking at it. Red fruits are usually sweeter and easier to digest. For baboons, red also signals readiness for sex. As primates moved into trees and away from the source of smells on the ground, sight became more important than smell. After all, primates can see further than they can smell. With less ability to pick up smells and pheromones in the air, primates needed more visual cues for sex. Even when the great apes emerged and evolved to spend more time on the ground, the advantages of full-color vision continued.